Good morning. This is Frank Root from the TLR development team, and we're here this morning in St. Charles, Missouri at Smack Track doing some testing the morning after the J Concepts Nationals. And we're running the all new 22 4.0 buggy today. And I wanted to take this opportunity to share that vehicle with you. We're really excited about it. The whole development team, we've put a lot of time and effort into the 4.0. And what we've done is we've taken the successful 3.0 platform and some of the parts that we've had to add on, whether it be a laydown conversion or other things, we've built all of those improvements into the 4.0 with even more updates that are going to improve the performance for you. So what I'm going to do here is I'm going to basically go over the different parts of the car that are improved, how they're better, and give you basically a wrap up at the end so you can appreciate all the awesomeness that the 4.0 will bring you. So first thing I'm going to show you, we already have it on, is the all new 4.0 body here. It's low and sleek, and it does two things to improve performance. That kind of low and sleekness still creates downforce, but not the kind of downforce that really kind of makes the car locked in or rigid, especially on a high grip surface like carpet or Astro or really high bite clay. And then the second thing it does is it lowers the weight of the body, and the bodies do weigh a considerable amount, so getting that weight lower really does help improve the CG of the car. Now that we've covered that, I'm gonna go ahead and pull the body off here and we'll go over the rest of the car. So we're gonna start in the front end, and basically with the front end we have the new short course spindle. Now that was developed in conjunction, knowing that the 4.0 was coming. We have the trail adjustment, we have the Ackerman adjustments, and the big thing that we did for the 4.0 is we have an axle height adjustment or spindle height adjustment of 4 millimeters now. So we used to have a 2 millimeter adjustment, and now it's 4, and the extra 2 millimeters is the axle going higher. And what that does is it really allows us to correct the roll center at the lower ride heights that we would run on carpet or AstroTurf. So on those surfaces, you're running 16, 17, 18 millimeters of ride height. And to run that low, you really need to raise the axle, which actually moves the arm back down out of a really aggressive roll center position for those types of surfaces. Keeps the car flatter in the turns and keeps it from rolling over really crazy. And then the number 2 Ackerman arm has a really low ball stud position for the spindle turnbuckle, and what that does is it keeps the bump steer correct for when you're running that axle really really high up. So you have your kind of adjustment out here to run the corrected roll center and correct bump steer when you're running on a carpet or Astro surface. We also revised the caster block and moved the landing pad where the spindle meets the caster block. We moved it back a little bit, and it gives the front end 3 degrees more steering throw, which really improves steering in tight turns, 180s on indoor tracks, on 180s on like carpet tracks. It really helps the car get around those turns a lot quicker. So in addition to that, we also have a new 12 millimeter front axle. So the 3.0 had the 12 millimeter front axle, but the 4.0 axle is actually a millimeter longer. And what that allows us to do is to use 2 half millimeter shims on the axle. So you put both shims on the inside of the spindle and you're running the same track width as the 3.0. You put one shim on each side, you've widened the track width a half millimeter, and you put both shims on the outside, you widen it a millimeter. It's been a really popular adjustment for the 22 3.0, but something that's gonna come standard on the 22 4.0, and with the corrected axle length, it makes everything stack up correctly when tightening it down on the wheel bearings. Also, on the inside of the front suspension, we have an all-new front pivot that's going to be included in the kit in addition to the standard 25-degree pivot. And that new front pivot is an HRC front pivot that's molded, and it moves the inner front hinge pins up about 1.75 millimeter. And what that does is it also helps correct the roll center in the front suspension and basically gets the arms back to the correct angle when you're running that 16, 17 millimeter ride height on carpet or Astro. So we really have a carpet Astro friendly front end suspension built in with the parts in the kit. Now, moving to the middle of the chassis, we have an all new chassis here, and it's a little bit wider here in the center, but what that allows us to do is to run a brick pack or saddle packs all the way forward in the laydown configuration. So now the battery pocket is long enough to run not only a laydown with a shorty pack, but a laydown with a brick pack and then you can also take that shorty pack and mount it further forward in the car. And what that allows you to do is to get the weight bias really dialed in for any type of surface, whether you're running dirt or clay, and you would want the shorty pack kind of all the way back when you're running the laydown transmission. If you're running on AstroTurf or carpet, you're gonna wanna move that battery further forward to get the weight bias more correct for those types of surfaces. And the same thing with the electronics. We do have an all new battery strap that comes with the car also. So you have the standard 3.0 long battery strap. You have a short battery strap that is the length of a shorty pack. So when you run the laydown configuration with a shorty pack, you can run that short battery strap, move the battery mount back, and then you can also run your electronics further back in the car to improve the rear weight bias with the laydown configuration. When you're running a stand-up configuration, you run the long battery strap with the mount where it is here on the laydown, and that'll give you your full range of adjustment when running a shorty pack or brick or saddle packs in the stand-up configuration. We also have mud guards here that are made from the Stifazole material right off the bat, so it helps improve the flex characteristics of the chassis, and it's been a really popular upgrade that we've been running on the 3.0, but it's gonna come standard on the 4.0. Now, this is where the magic happens. We're gonna go over the rear suspension. So obviously, we have an all new rear end for laydown coming with the 22 4.0. And we have an all new transmission, we have an all new waterfall, motor plate, shock tower. Everything really works around that new transmission case. And the best thing about the transmission case is that we've built in some inserts that will adjust diff height. So you have your standard diff height, same as what the 22-3.0 transmission or the dirt laydown comes with. And then we have a plus 3.5 millimeter diff height that raises the diff 3.5 millimeters, again, for when you're running those really low ride height, 16, 17, 18 millimeter ride height. It corrects the bone angle and helps with the roll center adjustment that you would do on the rear hubs. Also, the transmission's designed so that the current diff and top shaft that we use still fit. And then therefore the SR diff and the SR top shaft, the DDS system, will fit right in the 4.0. So you can still run the really light drivetrain and you're all ready to go for stock. Now, we also have a new motor plate here, and we did something pretty cool with the motor plate. We have a little shield that covers the spur gear on the bottom that really locks in a cool way. We also have a kind of a bar that runs up the top of the motor plate that covers and protects the spur gear from the body touching down on it. The waterfall is really low profile, nice and sleek, and it stays nice and low so that we can use that low profile body in the rear without having any clearance issues. And then the last feature, which I think is one of the trickiest things we did on the car, is we have the motor plate mount an anchor to the waterfall itself. So those two parts anchor together rather than having a mount on the motor plate and then that mounting down to the chassis. So it's just a really clean, efficient way to tie those parts together to have the correct chassis flex. Another thing that we did on the 4.0 is we built some little tunnels into the mud guard so that you're able to get the your 2.5 or 2 millimeter driver through there to adjust your lower motor screw. So now you can get a standard driver, no ball end needed, right in and adjust both the top and bottom motor screws to take your motor out, to change your pinning gear, to set your gear mesh, whatever you need to do. No problem with the parts fully installed in the car. You can get to everything you need to get to. Now, we also have the all new rear tower that fits on top of this transmission. So the tower bolts onto the transmission. The transmission has aluminum threaded inserts, so there's plenty of strength there. And then the new tower is offset. So you can offset it forward, run your shocks on the front of the tower, the front of the rear arm, which the arms have been modified to have screw holes for that. And then that also allows you to run the wing mount and the wing a little bit further forward. That's really good for high bite surfaces, clay, astro, and carpet. You get the wing further forward, you don't really reduce rear grip, but you create more mid-corner kind of rotation and steering, which improves lap times. And that's been a really good adjustment. You can also basically take the tower off and you flip it around 180, put the wing mount on the other side, and the wing is in its same position as the 3.0. The shocks are on the back of the tower and they're on the back of the arm, and you have both of those adjustments right there. All you do is flip the tower around, mounts right on down. We also have an all-new wing mount that comes on the 4.0, and this wing mount screws the rear wing on. So there's an angle shim, there's 2 degrees built into the wing mount, and then there's a 2-degree shim, so you can run 0, 2, or 4 degrees of wing angle. You have a nice washer here that goes on the top that connects the two wing mounts together to create a really rigid configuration. And obviously we're using our 6.5-inch wing here, and basically everything bolts together with the two M3 flathead screws, and it's just really easy, really clean, really trick, and it's kind of the way that people want to mount their wings these days, so we've accommodated for it. We also have a new rear camber block, and what we've done with the camber block is it still has the innovative design where you can adjust up and down using the insert. So you have the -1 insert, +1 when you flip it over, and the 0 insert. But what we've done is we've revised the hole locations for the rear camber link. So before we had an inside and an outside hole. Well, on the new camber block, the middle hole is the old inside hole, and now we have a half hole further inside and a half hole further outside. So we have a hole between what used to be inside and outside. We have a hole where inside used to be, and a hole that's further inside. And that further inside hole has been something that we've really liked on a lot of surfaces. It really helps the car when it rolls down. It doesn't roll down and back as quick. It kind of smooths that transition. So when you're landing a jump, kind of going into a turn, and you don't want the rear end to dive down too hard and become unstable, you run that furthest inside hole and it really smooths out the rear end. It also helps it get back out of the set a little bit more smoothly when driving around tighter turns on 180s at speed. We also have a new Gen 2 rear hubs are going to come on the 22 4.0, and that's the composite body with aluminum plate. It's a really durable solution. You get the best bearing fit with the bearings going into the composite piece. The ball studs screw through the aluminum. The aluminum's not threaded, so it goes through there and screws into the composite material, so the ball studs don't want to back out or get loose. And then you have the aluminum to create the lateral support that the ball stud needs to stay in the composite material, because the ball studs don't pull up. They pull or push out when you crash and you put a load on the side of the wheel. So now you have that aluminum plate on top to support the ball stud so that it can't break out or pull out when you have that type of impact. Now with the 4.0, you're going to receive not only the standard axle height rear hub, but you also get the molded body for a +3.5 millimeter axle height. And that +3.5 millimeter axle height is basically the equivalent of raising the axle in the front. It helps fix the roll center in the rear for when you're running on carpet or Astro, and you have those really low ride heights, 16, 17, 18 millimeters. So those are the new parts in the rear suspension. The entire 3.0 rear suspension, transmission, shock tower fits right onto the 4.0. So you're getting the stand up and lay down parts both in the kit. You don't have to buy a conversion kit to run either or. You get both of them in the kit. Everything fits. We even retrofitted, updated the 3.0 rear shock or rear wing mount so that it also is a screw-in type wing mount. So you get basically everything that you need for any type of grip level. So if you're running on a loose outdoor track, you got your stand-up transmission, you got your wing further back, you got your shocks on the back of the arm, you can run your battery all the way back, you can really create rear grip. If you're running on an indoor clay track that has good traction, you're probably going to run the lay down. You're probably going to run the shocks in the front and the wing a little further forward. You're going to run a shorty battery, but you're going to run it all the way back. And you're going to run the short battery strap with your electronics back up against where the battery mounts to really get that weight bias where you want it. And then if you're running on carpet or Astro, you're going to raise the diff on the lay down configuration. You're going to raise the axle on the hub. You're going to raise the axle on the front spindle. You're going to run the high roll center in the front. And you're going to run the long battery strap with your electronics mounted up front and your shorty pack or your saddle packs move further forward. So we really have a car that is completely adjustable for all types of grip levels, for all types of surfaces, so that you can get it dialed in for your driving style on the track that you choose to run on. And the best thing is, you don't have to buy anything else to do that. So the last thing, and I saved this for last because it kind of concerns the entire car, we have all new stiff as L parts coming with the 22 4.0. So Stiff is a really high glass composite that we've been testing, and we've had really good success with our mud guards on the 22 3.0. Well, now the 4.0 is going to come with not only the Stiff mud guards, but it's also going to come with Stiff front arms, rear arms, stand up rear shock tower, and both waterfalls, lay down and stand up. What the Stiff material does is it creates a more rigid arm. We've actually found it to be more durable during testing, which is, was a awesome improvement that we weren't entirely expecting. And that material and the stiffness of the parts really makes the car feel like it's heavier. It's more stable, but it doesn't lose its nimbleness around the track. It doesn't feel lazy. It just feels more stable compared to the softer parts. So instead of the parts kind of flexing and then flexing back or flexing inconsistently, now that the arms are hard on the tower and the waterfall, now the suspension is able to do all of the work. The suspension is able to roll. The shocks are able to do their work when you're landing jumps, for example. And it's really made the car a lot more consistent and a lot easier to drive lap to lap. So the biggest improvement probably is just landing jumps. The thing lands like a dream right now. It's just plush, stuck, and you're on to the next turn. And it's really been a great improvement for the 22 4.0. So just to recap, we have the all new body, chassis, mud guards. You have the ability to run the battery forward, backward, stand up, lay down. You run the battery back for like a lay down dirt car. You get the short battery straps. You can have your electronics back. On the front end, we have the adjustable roll center with both the spindle and the inner pivot. You have the additional steering throw, 3 degrees of steering throw. You have the axles, which can be adjusted at a standard offset or plus half millimeter, plus 1 millimeter. You get to the rear end, you have the complete stand-up configuration and lay-down configuration included in the kit. You have the screw-down wing button. You have the shocks on the front, the shocks on the back adjustment with lay-down. You have the new rear camber block with the new inner camber link positions. And you have the rear hubs that have the adjustable roll center, both up and down for carpet and standard dirt running. So the best thing about the 22 4.0 is you're going to get all of these parts, all of these features, right? The Stiff the lay-down, the stand-up, the high roll center, the low roll center, all those parts come in the kit. And not only do they come in the kit at $329.99 as the MAP price. That's the same price as the 22 3.0, and you're getting a lot more in terms of being able to dial this car in for your track and your driving and the surface that you're on. You have all the parts you need in the box, and that's something that no other car can boast. And we think you're gonna win a lot of races with this car, just like we're gonna do. We're gonna have a lot of fun, and we're gonna take that championship winning momentum from the 22 platform and take it forward with the 22 4.0. You'll be seeing these kits shortly, and I can't wait to share them with you.